Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
How are you all?
All good.
क्या सब काम में बिजी लग रहे हैं यार?
सब कुछ आपने?
नहीं.
Okay, all done with your work?
Yes.
बाद में करते हैं. आज में
तो All right, that's great. All right. So seems like everything is going good as compared to last 2 weeks. If we calculate over, if we check our card, or if we check how we are speaking to the customers, and if we are going to calculate everything, if we consider everything, I believe everything is going good. Everyone is giving their 110%, I would say, and they are trying to make sure that they are giving the best services or best help with or answering customers' questions or helping customer to understand what we are exactly into. On giving a good services to the customer, right? We are working towards it, and I believe we are getting a positive response from everyone, and I believe that's really appreciated. So I would really like to appreciate all the team leaders who are working hard with all of you guys, so that you can make sure that everything is going smooth, right?
Yes.
So I really appreciate all the team leaders, all the supervisors who are standing behind you and helping you in case you have any kind of questions. So that's very nice. Thank you so much, guys. All right. So, what's the current score, guys?
88.
Galat jawab.
Overall team.
Obviously.
Okay, 87.
Perfect. So, what do you think? What is different, which is happening now, which has never happened before? We have not reached 87 until now. By the end of the month, like if you check, पहले का अगर हम लोग ट्रेंड निकाले तो वी आर नॉट रीच 87 84 85 वाज अ परसेंटेज व्हिच वी यूज्ड टू टच फ्रॉम दिस मंथ इट्स 87 व्हाट डू यू थिंक व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड
दैट आई वांट थिंग इज समहाउ हेल्पिंग अस आई मीन टू इंप्रूव आई मीन वी आर गेटिंग फीडबैक ऑन द स्पॉट सो दैट वी कैन बी रेडी फॉर द नेक्स्ट चैट एंड कैन इंप्लीमेंट दोस थिंग्स ऑन
पॉसिबल सो व्हेनेवर your supervisor, your team leaders are sitting beside you and giving you feedback and letting you know what you need to do. Instead of doing this, you need to do this, and that is actually helping you. So whenever in future, if in case you're getting the same scenario or a similar scenario wherein you are coming up with a similar scenario and you have to type something or you have to give some information to the customer, at that particular point of time, you're thinking of that, "Arey yaar, maine ye kiya tha, mere supervisor ne mujhe ye bola tha karne." Then you are doing this. Right?
Yes.
That is actually helping you guys. Great. What about you, David?
My score doesn't look that good. I need more feedbacks because I have been not given any live monitoring feedbacks.
Live monitorings, I believe I'll speak to the team leaders and I'll check if in case they can take care of the free trial as well. Because normally what I'm trying to do is I'm doing the monitorings for you guys. I'm trying to give adequate response, or I would say the proper way of how you can take charge for the free trial support and what are the things you can cover in free trial support. But until unless someone is not sitting beside you and guiding you what you need to do now, how you can turn the situation and ask this question or that question, which covers all the parameters of the key behaviors, that will not be possible. You will not be able to cover everything, because I've seen most of the times a qualified key behavior is being impacted a lot, wherein you have to ask for the list of contacts. We have to confirm, we have to ask, or we have to check the list of contacts in the app, and we have to inform the customer. I can see you have so many number of contacts in the app, and then we have to check the total number of active campaigns and contacts active in the campaign. And apart from that, we have to also ask from the customer if they are through with the campaign functionality, or do they know how to use Infusionsoft application. And if they know how to use the Infusionsoft application, we need to take a feedback as well from the customers of how are you comfortable, or how is your experience until now when you use the Infusionsoft.
This is applicable for free trial.
This is applicable for free trial, just for your information, if in case you are being shifted to free trial for future. So that's your future planning. I'm just giving you a gist of what are the things which will be included when you go to the free trial. So these are the things which are being included. So these are the couple of things, like 5-6 things which are very difficult for a person to cover. So that is the reason I've try to give them a different, create a scenario on how you can get that particular thing achieved when you are actually communicating with the customer. That should be in silent mode. Silent. All right. Giving more silent mode. Right? Silent?
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you so much. All right. So that is what we need to make sure that we are keeping everything in mind, and we are just giving our best when we are chatting with the customer, when we are talking to the customer, when we are answering customer's question, or when we are having a normal conversation with the customer in terms of product, in terms of normal, in terms of his business, if he is giving any business information, we are acknowledging to what he is saying, or we are helping him understand about what our product is all about and what are the features which will be helpful to the customer, depending on the customer's requirement. Until and unless we probe.
Yes.
Because we have to probe. Probing is the thing which comes into picture at any given particular point of time. The reason why I ask every one of you on all the calibration session, or normally when I speak to you guys, I do say that ask probing questions from the customer. Ask what is the end goal. If in case there is a complicated situation wherein you are not able to understand anything, whether it's in terms of product, whether it's in some kind of a technical thing which a customer is asking, please make sure that you are asking from the customer what exactly are you referring to by that thing. Because there are a couple of things which can have a multiple reasons. Also, a lot of times it happens that there are terms which customers are using which are coming from some other software which are not being used over here. But similar kind of things, we are also, that functionality is also available in the Infusionsoft. So that is the reason we need to ask from the customer what exactly are they referring to. I'm sorry, I'm not able to understand what you are trying to say. Can you please elaborate a bit more of what is the end goal you are expecting from the Infusionsoft, or what is the exact feature you are expecting from our? So obviously the customer will be talking to you in a layman term that this is what I'm expecting. I'm expecting emails to be sent in a bulk. I want the emails to go automatically in a given point of time. Like I want to set up a timer and I want to send an email, or I want to segregate a list of contacts in the app so that I can search and I can send that particular list and broadcast or email. Or I'm looking out for a sales pipeline. I want to sell my products. I'm looking out to sell my ebook. Or I want to create a subscription product, something sort of that. So that is what the explanation we will be getting from the customer until and unless we are not probing. If we are probing, we will be getting the explanation. So that is what we need to make sure that we are concentrating more on as of now. All right. So now, coming back to what I have in my plate for today. Now, it's been a long time. We have not discussed the key behaviors. So let's see how much everyone remembers. I'm not going to ask you to blindly go ahead and read it and let me know what are the key behaviors, what does the key behavior consist of. I'm going to open the sheet in front of you. I'm going to ask you to go through it and give me an explanation as in what is your expectation, like what do you think about that particular key behavior. All right?
Yes.
Will that be okay? No blind game.
Yes.
Open book test. Okay. All right. Just 1 minute. All right, let's start. So who will start?
Muzambil.
Why Muzambil?
He's also a part of calibration.
He's also part of calibration, but the basic things, you guys are on chat, you guys should have more understanding.
Okay.
He will be giving his insight towards the end.
Okay.
He will be giving his insight to towards the end, because if he is going to share some information, because he is a part of JMS session, he is a part of all the training sessions which we are attending. But you guys are not attending. He's getting something. A JMS session, you guys are not attending that because he's attending because we need to be calibrated. Because he knows what needs to be done. I want you guys to understand what needs to be done. And later, if in case any correction is required, he will correct you. Or he will give you his insight. Apart from what you have informed or what you just told, there is something else which you need to do if in case it's required. Alright, David, let's start from you. Handle efficiently.
Wrong professional friendly greeting.
Okay.
3 minutes response time or less.
Mm-hmm.
Follow proper hold procedure when applicable.
Okay. So what does it consist of completely?
So firstly, it comes from professional friendly greeting.
Mm-hmm.
So prompt is like you should be very quick.
Mm-hmm.
Quick while replying to the customer. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
In a professionalism, like a professional manner. So like we do it on the chat every time.
Yes.
And it should be in a friendly manner, like a friendly way. Mm-hmm. So they should be not like arrogant or something.
Okay.
3 minute response time or less.
Alright.
So here it comes about the dead air part.
Okay.
Where the response time between the customer and us should be within 3 minutes. It should not exceed it.
Who is the response?
Our response.
Our response.
Yeah, with respect to the customers.
There are a lot of scenarios when we consider the 3 minutes to dead time. What are the scenarios which are being covered in this?
So like,
there are a lot of, but I want you to at least come up with 3 scenarios wherein you or everyone will be marked or will be taken down in this particular key behavior when we check response time. What are that?
So
one reason you gave wherein the customer is throwing a question and we need to, like the customer is saying something and we need to respond within 3 minutes.
Yes.
What apart from that?
So second, if you are like you have asked a question from a customer,
mm-hmm,
and he isn't replying within 3 minutes,
mm,
so that can be like marked down. If we don't reply back, as in like, are you there? Are we still connected?
Yes. So checking with the customer if they are connected, if the chat is connected. All right. Apart from that,
and third is if you are giving some information to him.
Mm.
And while you have asked some questions also,
mm,
so the last reply from the customer, there should be only 3 minutes where you should ask him, are we still connected? So it's like I can help you with an
That's
example.
The same scenario.
I can help you with an example. So second is like, okay, if I'm talking to Matt and I asked him something,
mm,
where I'm not giving him any information, I've just asked him like, what's the name,
mm,
and event and responsive.
Mm.
So I should like ask. Like to make sure if it's connected, so I should throw my responsive statement.
Right.
My third scenario is where, like, I'm talking to him. He was also talking, and I was giving him some information. And later, while in between, I asked him some question.
Mm.
And then from the first, he read our reply about the information part. Like he told that what is Infusionsoft. I told this is Infusionsoft.
Mm.
I replied, and it's been 2 minutes. Okay, and then I asked him a question. So that should not be counted. Like from our reply to next our reply, there should be 3 minute gap. There should be reply between like his first minute and our fourth minute. So that's what the third scenario is.
So you got it, Vishal, what he wants to say?
Okay. So it was a lot of confusion.
No. I would think in that way, like if in case there is some scenario which is somewhere wherein he has shared some information with the customer and then customer said something, alright, and later he again asked some question and still he needs to make sure that when there is a customer response, after that when we are replying, there should not be, it should not exceed for more than 3 minutes.
This is the first one.
This is the second.
Third scenario, which we are on right now.
There's one more scenario where, what I think so he was trying to do it, and I'll help you with an example. For example, customer said that, yes, I can you help me what Infusionsoft will do for me, right? So, then you answer, what online there?
Kabhi?
Online answer, was it?
Ah, online, but it's free to, yeah, I'm live view.
Live
view, I
live view.
Yeah?
Online view, I live view.
Ah, so yeah, free to add actually my part of this case, so do we assign that over here?
Okay, yeah. So I'll just continue. So, for example, customer says that, yes, I want to know about Infusionsoft. Okay. So we, and also he have asked about some specific, to know about specific feature, for example. So we give him the answer. So on the second minute, first minute we give the answer. On the second minute we give more answers, specific answer.
More specific answer.
Yes. Okay. And then later on we put a question to him that, that may I know your business detail. Okay. This was on the third minute. Okay. So from that third minute we will try to calculate the 3 minutes of response time. It will be counted as from the first when
the last day.
The last one, right?
Okay.
That was the country line.
That is what was the third scenario which we actually explained or which we actually gave. Wherein if in case he has given some information, customer asked a question, he replied to that question. Customer asked a question and then he replied to the question, and later if in case he wants to share some more information or after the customer's response, if he is still taking more 3 minutes, will that be counted as a dead air? Yes, definitely that will be counted as a dead air, because we need to make sure that the response time in between customer and the rep does not exceed more than 3 minutes.
Correct. Now, I also have one question from with David. I just wanted to know, for example, if customer asks that, like, yes, what is influencer? Okay, you give him the answer. And then later on, customer is not responding. So what will you do?
Class, like, I'll throw my unresponsive statement.
Why are you sure?
Okay, no. If he's asking a question and he went and responded, so I'll reply to his answer. Like,
okay.
I'll reply to his question and then I'll ask him, like, is he connected and he's still connected with
him. Why? Because, see, if I get an answer, I'm not bothered to ask you anything. For example, I want to know,
okay,
what is influence of you give me the answer. Yeah. Yes, okay. Then what next?
There can be like two scenarios there.
So we cannot consider him as an unresponsive unless and until if he asks something, he's not replying for it.
But
correct me if I'm wrong, Steve.
So if a customer, see, I have thrown him the answer, and okay, in rep we can see if the customer has read our statement or not.
And still he is not replying. What happens then?
If he read and if he's not replying, so I can go ahead and ask him, are you there?
Okay. No, I hope you understand my question. I hope you got it. You can put such kind of questions.
I hope I was able to answer this question.
Yes.
So yep, then we're done.
Alright. In a simple way, what I'll explain you in simple terms what he said. What he gave you was a canned response.
Yeah.
I'll give you something in small, like which will give you more insight on, you'll be getting more clarity on how the situation goes on. Customer throws a question, can you please share some light on how Infusionsoft works? You gave a one-liner. And then you're just checking with the customer. Hope you have more clarity on it. Just let me know if in case you're looking out for something specific. So you're just checking with the customer. If in case the information you have shared with the customer, he's able to understand that situation, he's able to understand the features which we are giving. Also on top of it, you're actually asking from the customer, is there anything specific you're looking out for? Still, if in case, after a couple of minutes, customer is not responding, hey, are you there? Are we still connected? Hey, are you there is a statement which we have to use. Are we still connected is not being resolved now. Hey, are you there? After 2 minutes or max 3 minutes or maximum 3 minutes. After that, again, if in case customer is not responding, then you have to throw a responsive statement stating the chat. You can initiate a chat later. That statement, the last statement, you guys are from.
So yeah, in short, we unresponsive means like we are expecting some answer from customer, then he is not responding. So that would be the main reason after which we can put an unresponsive.
So to make it more easy, if I throw him a question,
yes,
and if it's not replying, so I'll be like, yeah, are you there? Yes. And if I give him an answer and then he's not replying, so I should have hope my like
hope I was, so you can be able to answer your question, yes. Okay, or hope you have more clarity on how Infusionsoft works. Hope I was able to explain you properly what are the features which are included in Infusionsoft. Okay. On top of it, there is one more benefit for you guys, wherein I'm not going to mark you down in case it's a cut-to-cut 3 minute a day time. If I'm able to see the minute Not the seconds. Not the seconds. And that's what I'm trying to elaborate on. Not the seconds. The first response was at 2 minutes 59 seconds. So what time you'll be able to see over here? 2 minutes? You'll not be able to see 59 seconds.
Okay.
So it's a 2 minute. And later if you are responding at 6 minute 1 seconds, I'm going to mark you down because it's a 4 minute data.
So that's not a benefit, that's a benefit for you.
That's a benefit for you guys because you are getting 4 minutes instead of over here written as 3 minutes.
That's what I'm telling.
I'm giving you a gist of it. I'm just giving you an overview. A benefit there. Yahan pe 3 minute likha hai, I'm still giving you a benefit of 4 minutes.
Just to make it easier for you, David, when we are asking the question to the customer, we can wait for the answer.
Yeah, I got
However,
it.
Don't take it as a leeway.
Yeah.
To make it professional, mm-hmm. when customer is coming up with question, you don't have the leeway to wait for 3 minutes. You should be as quick as possible.
Yes.
So if we are telling you 3 minutes, don't take it as a leeway that you have a right to wait for 3 minutes after customer's question.
There is chapter, that's the reason.
That's okay.
What
people are taking it as a leeway. There are people who are taking it as a leeway.
For me, when it comes to technical, I don't like 3 minutes very much.
Simple. So you have to answer the question as soon as possible. However, before 3 minutes.
Simple. Right?
But you are throwing your question, then you can wait for customer's reply
for at least 3 minutes. And then within 3 minutes, just make sure you are replying to the customer or you're just checking the customer if they are still connected. मैं पहला स्टेटमेंट तुम लोग का देख रहा हूँ सेकंड मिनट पे या थर्ड मिनट पे थर्ड मिनट के बाद अगर मेरे को डायरेक्टली सेवेंथ मिनट पे तुम लोग का सेकंड स्टेटमेंट दिखाई दिया ना विदाउट एनी कॉन्वर्सेशन इन बिटवीन कस्टमर एंड यू तब मैं मार्क यू डाउन थर्ड मिनट के बाद अगर फिफ्थ मिनट में कस्टमर ने रिस्पॉन्ड किया उसके बाद तुम लोग सिक्स्थ या सेवंथ मिनट के बीच में कभी रिस्पॉन्ड करो आई स्टिल कंसीडर इट बिकॉज कस्टमर के रिस्पॉन्स के बाद यू टू कपल ऑफ मिनट्स टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू द कस्टमर्स क्वेश्चन दैट्स फाइन आई एम नॉट गोना मार्क यू डाउन एक दो मिनट वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट एन आंसर But still make sure you guys are quick in answering the customer's question.
Mm-hmm.
Alright? Perfect. Uske baad
proper hold procedure when applicable. Matlab? So, inform the customer as in why are you asking time from him. So,
set expectation with the customer the reason why you are putting him on hold. And make sure you are coming back in the given time. Alright?
Yes.
Perfect. Next, answer question.
Sufficiently and quickly answer customers' questions while building value leading to conversation. Adequately clarified to understand customers' question and prove the provided accurate information.
Right.
So, for sufficiently and quickly answered customers' question while building value leading to conversation. Basically, we have to give appropriate answer what customer has asked from us.
The question
point
to point has asked.
In case if we have any doubt, we can probe in so that it can be.
So that we can understand the customer's question and we can
exactly
be on the same path. Perfect.
Second
point.
Adequately clarified to understand customer's question.
Probing.
Probing.
Paraphrasing.
Yeah.
Perfect. Probing with paraphrasing.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
If in case we are not able to understand the question of the customer, we can ask probing questions from the customer. What exactly are they expecting or what exactly they are looking out for from our end. And also, we are making sure that we are on the same page with the customer. Just confirming. I understand that this is what you're looking out for. Is that correct? Take confirmation from the customer and then continue.
Provide accurate information.
Like self-explanatory. We need to make sure that the information which we are sharing with the customer is correct, appropriate, and foolproof. 100%?
Yes.
Don't give incomplete information. Make sure that
the point crisp and
clear. If in case you are sharing some information with the customer, just make sure that you are giving complete information, not half information.
Yes.
Customer agar pooch raha hai ki, what are the features I'll be getting when I have purchased a basic package of $99. You're saying you'll be getting unlimited emails. That's it. If you are saying that you'll be getting unlimited emails. What are the features I will be getting when I purchase a $99 basic package? So it's our responsibility to let customer know that you'll be getting one user license, unlimited emails, 500 contact list, contact base, wherein you can save contacts up to 500. Maximum you can store 500 contacts in the application. You can send unlimited emails. You'll be getting a basic CRM functionality wherein you will be able to send email broadcast. you can create campaigns. Like this is the additional information which you can share.
Marketing automation,
sales pipeline is not available, e-commerce is not available. It's a basic marketing automation you'll be able to see with the 500 contact base, unlimited emails and one user license. Basic?
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Awesome? Clear?
Yeah.
Great. David, next? Okay, 1 minute. Do you have anything to share? Like if you want to. Or
no.
All good?
All good.
All good? Perfect. Next? Qualified?
David. Achha, this, we'll be completing this calendar till 9, right? Because actually Zibran ka early departure hai 9 o'clock ka.
Now we'll do it.
Okay.
10 minutes. Within 10 minutes we'll start. We'll complete.
So
we will not be able to discuss the
chat.
So we will not be discussing the chat, but we'll be completing this form.
Sure.
Be on the same page with everyone. Alright? David, let's start. Qualified?
The third parameter is qualified.
What
identify if the lead is an existing customer or an existing partner.
Okay.
Use resources to look up account information when applicable.
Yeah.
Gather leads, business and contact information when applicable.
Okay, so
first,
what does this consist of?
So first is identify the lead is an existing customer or partner. So when a conversation hits and you ask for the name or email address which has been already provided, so you have to check if he's an existing customer or existing partner. That's what we have to identify.
How can we identify?
Okay, so with the help of the email address, it's easily been given in the sales for that he's an existing customer or somewhere.
That's the second point. What about the first point? Identify the lead as an existing customer or existing partner. how we'll be able to identify the first point, not the second point.
So yeah.
Second point, you give me an explanation.
First,
and
yeah.
Check
okay,
for the email address in the sales.
So
first point.
To be more clear, you can like ask the customer if you are an individual user. Or have you working with them somewhere that is he
I got
related
your point.
To influencer or something?
I got your point. I got your point.
Yeah.
Another scenario. How will you identify if he's an existing customer? This was the one scenario which you gave. You can ask from the customer if he is an existing user or an existing partner, or if he is helping someone to create a business, or if he is looking out to buy. He's buying Infusionsoft application on behalf of a customer. Perfect?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
What is another scenario which comes into picture when we consider identify if the lead is an existing customer or existing partner? How can we identify that?
So, if a customer comes with a query with regards to Infusionsoft or something which is related to Infusionsoft, so
perfect.
We can go ahead and ask him that.
Correct. It's all about the choice of words which customer is using.
Yeah.
When he is talking to you, if he is more specific and asking about a particular functionality in the Infusionsoft, by default we will come to know that if he is an existing customer or if he is looking out for some kind of information in regards to Infusionsoft. If customer says, I've just signed up and I'm looking out on how I can use the Infusionsoft application. So I've recently signed up. So he's a free trial customer. Correct?
Yes.
Now, if in case customer says, I'm trying to check the reports, but I'm unable to see it. I want to check the totals in my total sales, but not able to see it. Or I'm trying to check the email status. I want to check the how many contacts are in hardbound or how many contacts have opted out in the application. It clearly says he's a paid customer. He's looking out to check. He's looking for a list of contacts who has opted out in the system or who has purchased a product in the application. So it simply states he is an existing customer. So it's better to transfer that chat to the technical support. Like guiding customer, he can initiate a chat. Or if in case he is a free trial customer, you guys can coordinate among yourself. And you can answer the chat.
Yeah.
Alright?
Yes.
Great. All clear?
Yes.
Second point has been covered. What about the third point?
So next, third one. The third
point. Third point.
Third point in the parameter.
Okay,
so gather leads, business, and contact information for applicable. So, if the prospect is looking for the feature which is an Infusionsoft, as in, see, there are some of them which some of the features what customer is looking not in Infusionsoft.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, there's no point of asking his business details if he's like not at all related to Infusionsoft. That's first scenario. Second is if the business details fits in our AOP. When it comes to applicable, that okay, this can be a possible lead.
So, and I have two scenarios at the moment.
It simply states gather business details and contact information and applicable. Don't complicate the scenario. Simple. What are the things which we need to cover when you consider this as a key behavior?
It's given you first name, last name, email address, name of the business, company name and phone number, time and time.
It depends on the situation.
That's
in case, what happens just in case customer is expecting. When we ask probing questions from the customer to understand what exactly they are referring to, only then we will be informing customer and we will be checking for the line of business he is into. If customer is saying, I want to send SMS and I need an application for sending the SMS, I understand your concern by directly you will not be able to send an SMS. However, if you want, you can integrate a third party application which will help you to do that. Hope that works for you. But you have to pay extra apart from that, apart from what amount you will be paying in the infusion software. Customer says, okay, I'm agreeing with it, I'm okay with it. Alright, great. Can you please let me know what's the line of business are you in? What's your line of business? Then we can capture this information, the basic information. First name, last name, email address. What is that? Nature of business. The nature of business, company name, website, phone number, time, and time zone. Correct? Perfect. Next, Zibran.
Set expectations for the next step, including the time frame. Basically, we need to, in case if we are scheduling a call for the customer, we need to be very clear about the time when he'll be receiving a call.
Everyone. I'm not pinpointing individually to you. It is happening with everyone. Everyone is saying, we have a time slot available from so and so. I'll ask my consultant to give you a call at so and so. Thank you so much. And that. You're not checking with the customer. You guys have started doing it. So it's good you are doing it, confirming it with the customer. Please let me know if that helps you or if this particular time slot suits you or if it's okay, I can schedule a call at this particular point of time. Take a confirmation from the customer always whenever you are fixing an appointment, because they are all business, small business owners, or the company, or possibly they are working in a small company wherein they require a CRM in order to access their database, or in order to save the contacts, or in order to maintain the list of contacts or their business functionality or all the database. So we need to make sure that we are seeking permission from the customer that this is the time. Will that be okay with you if I can fix an appointment, or if it's possible, you can let me know the best time. I can ask my product consultant to get in touch with you. Alright? Seek permission, get a confirmation from the customer.
No, automatically online.
Network issue,
right? Online.
Ek hi drift, the screen online.
The whole screen pe, but those will be offline.
Alright, people, set expectation including time frame. What's the next point, which says confirm best contact method and time zone? Just make sure you are confirming the contact method. If customer is saying, I need an email from your end, that's fine. Confirm the email address, send it to the product consultant, update in the notes. If in case he's saying, I'm okay with the time, like the time we discussed, confirm the time zone from the customer. What's the time zone you are located? Don't assume. Ask. Poochho customer se, kya time zone mein rehte ho? Give me your confirmation. Let me know what the time zone you are based at. In which time zone are you located? Are you currently at? And what's the time zone you need to call? Or like, which time zone are you simply located at? This simple stuff. Can you share your time zone? What's the time zone you're located at, so that I can ask my consultant to give you a call at the time we discussed. Time zone bataya, confirm karega, perfect. Then aage video. Third scenario, customer is saying I need a Skype call.
Possible.
Scenarios aate hain. 10 में से एक chat आएगा जहाँ पे customer बोलता है I need a Skype.
Perfect. Ask the Skype ID. बोला ही पूछता है कोई
क्यों नहीं पूछता अभी मैंने एक चैट पे पूछा खाली एक ही चैट पे अभी तक मेरे को दिखा
अभी रिसेंटली जो मैंने किया
फाइनल आया था पहले से चैट का स्काइप
No, what people used to do is I'll ask my product consultant to get in touch with you. Okay, ask them to Skype me. All right, no problem. I'll ask my consultant to send you an email, and accordingly send you an email invite, and further you can discuss it with the product. This is what was the pattern we used to do.
So we have ever
a smile on his
face.
We just need to make sure whenever we are speaking with the customer, if in case customer is interested to speak with the consultant or in Skype, inform the Skype ID and send it to the customer. Skype, link, ye, wo, jo bhi hai. Get a confirmation, write out an ID there. Khatam kar, baat hi khatam. Sir,
may I add one thing here?
Sir,
we had a discussion along with Lindsay and Ruby, wherein they stated that even if you forward to us Skype ID, collect the Skype ID from customers, then they send an email to any clients or visitors. They mentioned they have the form ready in it, in which they are offered to collect the Skype ID. So if you all thought your RM process, even if you forget to collect the Skype ID, they do it in the next process, which is
that's okay. But we can do our basics.
But we can do our best. Yeah, that's
all. We can try to capture the basic information.
So will that be counted as markdown?
But make sure you are asking me.
Okay.
BOD दिया है एक बार देखूंगा दूसरी बार करोगे तो मैं markdown कर दूंगा अभी बोल रहा हूँ
चलो यार next
question
हाँ the client
It's a client basic requirement. अभी अगर तुम लोग customer को बोलते हो
call के लिए पूछे तो कहाँ पर
So it's simple. If in case customer is saying I need a order from the product consultant, it's your duty to ask for the phone number.
Correct.
It doesn't mean that you are not asking for the phone number.
Same
with
Skype.
Right? So I'll mark you down. That's
okay.
Okay, next. Included a delightful close. That means I mean we need to acknowledge. I mean give a close.
Thank you for contacting.
What we are speaking or we are answering it, so we should like ask him. I hope this makes sense.
That's checking customer understanding.
So we should be like
So we customer understanding is soft skill, right?
Customer understanding, tera as such, yahan pe hai nahi.
Customer understanding means we want to understand whether we are
so
on
when
the
it comes
same
to
page
what
or
is,
we're on the same page.
Confirming if the customer is understanding what we are trying to say, that is known as customer understanding. We have shared some information with the customer and we just need to check if in case the information, the answer or the explanation which I have given does it make sense.
So there should not be a language barrier for customer, right? So even this
so
information is also, right? So if we are keeping, if you are asking customer that whether you have
understood
my explanation, so this means that we are just trying to understand
customer
whether customer
space,
wants to, customer can understand my language.
My language?
Yeah, my language is not only the Hindi Marathi wala language, but the language is technicality part or the thing which is basic.
Right. So just make sure, and also just make sure that whenever you are giving some information, it's relevant to what customer is asking. You should not be going in some other direction or some giving some other information or guiding customer to something else and the customer is asking something else. That is what direct the customer tone and face.
The customer is looking for soft skills. Soft skills, like you said, there are a lot of things apart from, you know, the
tone and face. Right.
So you, there is no standard process to earn delight on soft skills. That is as per customer's response. For example, the example which we shared in JMS, Matt, if you remember, the example was customers come up and say, I'm excited to, you know, use Infusionsoft I've heard a lot of things about Infusionsoft. I'm here, and you're responsible. All right, let me ask you the questions. So this is the
acknowledgement which was missing.
You have to show the same excitement what customer is showing.
Mirrored customers, tone and race.
Great to hear that. I'm sure that you will love to, you know, be a part of Infusionsoft. I'm sure that you will
like
Infusionsoft work towards your business. This kind of responses should be your response should be in context with customer's response. So if customer is excited, you should also be excited. Exactly what you need. You were asking for the updates.
I believe he has more knowledge or more in-depth information or explanation or understanding of the key behaviors. I'm very much thorough with that. Chalo, bye, man.
Take care.
Take
care.
Bye. Alright, so basically we need to make sure that we are matching the customer's face, and also whenever we are talking or we are chatting with the customer or we are communicating with the customer, we need to make sure the sentence which we are typing, it is sounding grammatically correct. And also proofread when you are writing something. Whenever you are pressing a send button or pressing an enter, make sure you are reading it once. You're not missing out on any things, and then you are pressing an enter and sending that message to the customer. All right, Nat?
Yeah.
All right, great. Had a natural conversation, no language barrier. It simply covers complete things, complete key behavior. Not complete soft skill thing which needs to be covered over here. All right. Last but not the least, it says documentation. Lead was created and saved in Salesforce in a timely manner. Internal notes were accurate and true. Paste the chat transcript in the lead section mode. Lead was created and saved in Salesforce. It happens by default.
Yes.
The chats are being by default gets connected to the Salesforce. Internal notes were accurate and true. Just make sure whenever you are entering the notes, it's self-explanatory of what customer is exactly looking out for. What is his interest into? If you have confirmed it, you have to confirm it with the customer. What exactly are they looking out for? Right? After that, need to make sure that if in case you can include the timing when you are scheduling a call
correct. With
the product consultant, because that will actually help the product consultant to take a look and directly call the customer, because he knows he's looking out for e-commerce functionality. He might can purchase sales pipeline, more interested in sending email broadcast and campaign functionality, needs a callback and so and so time. Whichever is the person who is responsible to contact the customer or the consultant.
Yes.
And they can quickly start doing the call because they don't have to go to read the complete chat, what was the communication, what was the conversation all about. So they can just read the notes and start the call. Alright? It will save their time as well as customer's time. Alright?
Yes.
All good? All clear?
Yes.
Any questions? David, any questions?
My KRA behavior is not in, but that's a question from the entire side.
Yeah, go ahead. Please ask.
So, as you said, I have been, most of my chats have been getting internally qualified in the pre-drive where I have to ask from the customer how much contact they have or have we tried our campaign with them.
Yes.
So, today I came up with a situation customer was in a rush and he wanted to migrate his Stripe Infusion account information to Infusionsoft. And he was a pre-trial user, and she was a pre-trial user. So Zach took the chat and it was a normal chat, then later he invited me. I took the chat and my job was to just schedule a call. So I don't know, I'm not sure if in this case I'll be get head down on the. But she was in a rush. So I asked this question from my side, but she was like,
what did you ask?
Yeah, I said that there's only three contacts and no campaigns as well.
So that's okay. You confirmed it.
But she did not reply. And she was like, I don't need the campaign with the feature. And again, she pasted the question that I'm looking for a callback. And that was a bit rude from that side. So will I be cut down or somewhere?
See, until unless you are attempting it from your end.
So I think in such case, so for example, Kasham is a rush and I want a call from your end to me so that I can understand more features.
That's
okay.
Right.
And customer is insisting, yes, please arrange me a call. Okay.
That's
again, right. If we are going to ask, yes,
see, if in case customer is insisting, she is in a hurry, I think to come up with because she has
so because you are
one thing, if in case you think there is an opportunity wherein customer is talking. And you have an opportunity where you can speak to the customer and create some bonding or something, you can give an attempt. I'm not saying compulsory. You can give an attempt.
I think I emphasize on that word attempt because...
Once try to ask. I can see that you have less number of contacts.
But if it's not relatable on the chat, like while on that conversation, on that point of time...
Customer is in a hush. In a rush, in a hurry, and she's expecting, please give me a call, please give me a call. Dobar bol diya aur wo bhi full bold
I checked because obviously it was the first time she there, but then do I ask for the feedback? And there was a like a rude answer.
That's okay, no problem. It's not teach my question. We'll become
people. I was afraid that I would be get marked down in that.
I know, I can understand that much of situation. In case customer is directly saying, I don't have time, give me a call, ask your consultant to give me a call. Obviously, I'm not going to mark it down. There was no trouble to be done, there was nothing was done because customer directly asked you to arrange for a call basis. So, I'm not going to take your time. See,
most of the time is I go.
Right. See, I'm not going to take that chat into consideration because we chat to monitor because I'm not getting any content to monitor you. I need a content, right? I need to understand what is your understanding of key behaviors. Jahan pe mujhe nahi dikhega ki you have not attempted anything or you haven't got an opportunity to say something or to ask something from a customer. Why would I take this chat? Any market, do jagah mein tere ko delight market, tere ko kyun dunga?
और एक क्वेश्चन ये इस सिनेरियो पे रिलेटेड है अगर कस्टमर्स जस्ट स्टार्टेड अ चैट के प्लीज अरेंज अ कॉल ठीक है सो कांट बी डू लाइक यस आई विल बी हैप्पी टू अरेंज अ कॉल विद आवर प्रोडक्ट कंसल्टेंट हाउएवर फॉर टू गेट इट मोर क्लैरिटी कैन आई
अंडरस्टैंड इट आई नीड टू आस्क सम क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम यू सो आई जस्ट नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आर यू लुकिंग फॉर
हां अगर ऐसा बोलने के बाद भी अगर फिर भी कस्टमर प्लीज अरेंज अ कॉल सो डायरेक्टली वी कैन गो इट राइट
ओके कस्टमर से तुम लोग एक बार अटेम्प्ट करो आस्क फ्रॉम द कस्टमर व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आर दे एक्सपेक्टिंग फ्रॉम आवर एंड इफ इन केस कस्टमर इज आंसरिंग दैट क्वेश्चन और स्टिल इंसिस्टिंग इफ इन केस कस्टमर इज आंसरिंग द क्वेश्चन दैट मींस ही इज इंटरेस्टेड ही और शी इज इंटरेस्टेड टू स्पीक ही हैज सम टाइम टू टॉक
सो कैसा है अगर कस्टमर अगर पूछे
सिचुएशन
तो उसको एक्नॉलेज करना कि यस आई एम रेडी टू अरेंज अ कॉल
But before I go ahead and arrange a callback or arrange a strategy call from with our product consultant, I just want to understand, is there anything specific you are looking for? Customer says so and so. Alright, great. Now, I just need to understand, do you have a good understanding of how Infusionsoft campaign works? He or she will say no, yes. So, usse tere ko pata chal jayega customer is actually in a hurry or not. If they have time, they will talk to you. So, start a
meeting. Agar aisa kuch hai business jo uska campaign ka kaam hi nahi hai. So as a situation mein puchna zaruri hai yes you are not I think you are not using any campaign so
I don't see you have created any campaigns it seems do you send regular emails to your contacts and I'm also able to see you just have 10 contacts I can see that you have 10 contacts in the application it seems a good amount of contacts do you send regular emails to the contacts are you sending a broadcast that's great you're sending a broadcast I don't see a campaign being created so that means on the spot you are keeping on sending emails to 10 people at one particular point of time.
So there's one more challenge with this because what happens we're getting challenged to self login so
activate
the problem kya ho raha hai madam ki hum log jab customer ke app mein jate hai na office of feature app mein office check karta jo used to pe app hai
GB303 login karo. There is a search on the left hand side top wherein we have to enter the app name. Then don't press enter. Press NIS. Click on it. It will give you the list of applications below. Then you have to click on the application.
I uninstalled Merlin because it wasn't helping me.
That's the basic thing. Until unless you're not gonna install Merlin, it's not gonna help you.
I was able to start talking by login page two, then open campaign, then I copy paste the customer's app name and then click login and then I'm able to log in. That's how.
Don't do that. Merlin is best. Merlin is the thing which will help you.
That was not.
Don't uninstall it.
Merlin ka kya hai? Merlin ka sab is app mein nahi chalta.
That's why.
Merlin ka sab app mein nahi chalta. Fir jab ye procedure follow karne aayenge na, to Merlin wo bhi nahi karne rehte.
That's why.
ऐसा फिर जब चैट में आते ना तो भी गए जंबल क्या कर रहे हो
समझ नहीं इनफॉरमेशन विच आई हैव रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द एसआर टीम मॉलिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट मॉलिंग के बगैर स्टेल्थ नहीं कर पाओगे दिलो पर में भी मुझे ये चीज बना मॉलिंग चाहिए ही चाहिए स्टेल्थ
न्यू जो वाई कर सो प्लीज इंस्टॉल इट
करके रहे इंस्टॉल
चेक एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट गाइस एज आई टोल्ड यू जैसा मैंने बताया GB303 में लॉग इन कर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड टॉप पे तेरे को ऐप नेम डाल जहां पे सर्च आता है ना वहां पे ऐप नेम डाल And click on NIS. Don't directly press enter. Click on NIS. उसके बाद तेरे को list of application side of कौन से contact है. Then click on the app name and it will take you to the right application. Try that. If you have
any customer help में आपने जब app name search करते थे वैसा
वाला. Yeah, right. If you have any difficulties, call me. I'll let you call me. All right. All clear.
Yes.
Documentation, everything clear.
Yes.
Perfect. Any questions? All right. Thank you so much, people.
Take care. Thank you, Vince.
Thank you, Carter.
Thank you.